welcome to the Hungara Ring in Budapest. You'll have to forgive the hat and glasses. I know it's not very personable, but I've just stepped out of the 600LT. I have insane helmet hair and it's sunny, hence me effectively cloaking my face. Anyway, welcome here. The track drive of this car is actually under embargo, so I can't bring you any content fresh from the track just yet. But I thought, what would be an interesting insight, and because I love bringing you guys behind the scenes on things, is what it's like at a car launch. Now, we go on these things all the time, and all you guys see is the end result, which is a 10-minute polished video of a lovely production that is focused on the topic at hand, which is typically the car being launched. But what goes on while we're here? We're here for hours and hours and hours. There's often multiple people from the car world, and there's also all sorts of cars and activities going on behind the scenes. So today we're going to take you behind the scenes on a car launch to show you what's what and speak to some of the guys who do this regularly. Bless it. So, here's somebody else who we're going to talk to about what it's like to be on a car launch. Here we are with someone who has flown. In fact, I've kind of joined you and flown halfway around.
I didn't realize you were in Vancouver.
Yeah, I came here from Vancouver. You come here from LA. We're both on the same time zone and absolutely shattered.
Yeah.
That aside,
yeah,
I'm sharing with these guys what it's like to be on a car launch.
So the cool part is, and I'm sure you're similar, I used to watch people like Chris Harris and any of the major magazines go to these launches and see them drive a P1 on track and go, oh, that's the coolest thing I've ever seen. Yeah. And so when I got invited, I've actually only done two major launches, which are the Senna in Portugal and then this here in Budapest.
Okay.
I was like, wow, this is what's
so
actually
awesome.
Happening. And the behind the scenes stuff, as I overheard you saying, is pretty cool. It's not just driving the car. All of a sudden, we've got mini electric P1s that we're messing around in. We've got a Senna here, a 675, a 720S.
Let's think about it. McLaren, they're based in Woking, England.
Yeah.
They could have easily just gone to Silverstone.
Easily.
And it would have cost them way less.
Yeah.
But they do sort of cherry pick the best circuits to highlight and exploit the characteristics of the car. This being one of them. So we've flown all the way to Hungary, and also there's more lifestyle to it because we spent all day yesterday exploring Budapest hot rods.
It was
Link
so
below.
Awesome.
It was so awesome. It was so good. So car launches are much more other than just the car, right?
It's
ultimately awesome.
It's the culture of the country that you're in, the history of the racetrack, the car itself,
the people,
the reason that the car is what it is, and then the people are probably the best part.
Let's start with the cars. Now we are here for the 600LT, so you would think, why would there be any other cars? But McLaren, they turn up big. Let's see, we've got 570Ss here. We have a 720S over there. But what you wouldn't expect to be here is a McLaren Senna, and yet there are two. There's one right here. I mean, how fantastic does this look? And there's also one all the way over there, which I shall share with you shortly. But this is what's great. You have basically the full model lineup turn up at the track, and it's of course because the journalists that turn up, these events normally run for weeks and weeks. I think this is a 3-week event. The McLaren team is out here for a long time, and you know, journalists like to talk about other things, compare with other cars from the group and the family, and so pretty much every model they do is here. I'm not sure if there's a 570 GT here. There might be one tucked away somewhere, but look, trucks turn up with a spider there. There's a spider there, and what's awesome is you get to see all the different specs that you necessarily wouldn't see next to each other. You might see them in isolation, but when they come together in one big group, it gives you a really good flavor of how these cars feel in various different specs. And this is the typical setup. We normally have the main star of the event on show inside the pits. What's great is not only is the car featured, but there are sort of exploded components from the car to give you an appreciation of maybe the details that you don't see. For example, these suspension components right here, aluminium wishbones. I think this is the kind of detail that McLaren cares about when it comes to saving weight and just adding overall technical ability and rigidity to a car. Speaking of which, this is the diffuser from the rear of the 600LT. That is a work of art. In fact, I would put that on my wall exactly like that. Look at it, it's absolutely gorgeous. The sculpture is incredible. Look how deep these canards are. just huge. And what's great is McLaren are particularly good at providing all of the information around the components you're staring at. Look at this lightweight carbon fiber aerodynamic bodywork, minus 7.2 kgs. And you can work your way down and see the weight saving from multiple components. These are just some of them. There's hundreds of components which add up to the LT ethos, and that's the 100 kilogram weight saving which goes into this wonderful car. This is a cool attention to detail. So here we have standard wheel bolts and titanium wheel bolts, and they've provided us with, let's take four, they've provided us with some scales to see how much these weigh. So one, two, three, four. So four standard wheel bolts, 247 grams. Let's see what the titanium ones are coming in at. One, two, I can tell just picking these up. This is ridiculous. They're so light. There you go, 154. So this is the detail McLaren goes to and cares about and highlights to you. They're not just numbers on a piece of paper. All of these components add up, and this is the ethos of this great brand. But this is what goes into the behind the scenes at a car launch that you guys don't always see. And I like bringing you along for these little bits, because this is stuff that we see that doesn't always get shared. Okay, so I've just spoken to Parker that this is only his second car launch.
No way.
Yeah, so I wanted to go to the other end of the spectrum and speak to a veteran of car launches. Can you even estimate how many you've done?
I can't. There's one today, there's one in another country tomorrow, there's one in another country the next day, there's one in another continent 2 days after that, so.
Yeah, and that's mostly how our months feel, really.
Yeah.
So the idea of this video is I'm taking these guys behind the scenes at a car launch to sort of show them what it's like. But in your experiences, what are car launches all about?
There's probably a lot more planning than people realize. Uh-huh. It's not like you turn up for 5 minutes, drive a car and go.
Nope.
Because you've got to work around their schedules, where the cars are, different people wanting cars for different things, different colors of cars. What are you going to film with? How do we all do different videos? How do you fit everything in? Are you driving on the road? Are you driving on the track? What are you actually saying? What are you saying on video?
For sure, absolutely.
So this is, my behind the scenes is probably obviously different to some people because I try and be really technical and detailed.
Yeah, yeah.
So my behind the scenes for a car launch is on the plane flight here, I'm reading all the documentation,
the
PDFs, I've downloaded everything.
I was about to say the same. That's interesting.
On top of what I've already know, but just to get it back there in the memory. Then you get here, you try and get your bearings, try and work out where you need to be, what the timings are, who are you driving with, what's your time slot. And then you've got to try and take in the car.
Absolutely.
And get your opinions about the car and work it out.
And often you don't have much time.
No, it happens.
I mean,
so
you arrived today.
I've only been on the ground for like an hour.
And you're, in fact, we're both flying out in about 2 hours.
I have 3.5 hours here in total.
Awesome.
Well, that's not normal.
Now, there's something outside, something special that I want to show you. It's just for you, since you're here today. And then we'll continue this chat later on.
All right.
Follow me.
Intrigued.
Thanks, guys. You've got a free car.
Hi, guys. I'm birthday. Welcome to my birthday.
Thanks for
the
doing
birthday
that, guys.
Cake on top of the 600. That's pretty cool.
Should we get a cut?
You want some?
Happy birthday, dude.
Thanks. All right. I
Something else you'll typically find at a car launch is benches and benches of media. Like this wonderful man here editing something to post later on. And of course, mutual colleagues.
I'm doing the same thing. I'm on a trader looking at cars for sale.
Car launches.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Mega.
Cool.
Coolest thing that we do, I think.
Isn't it?
It's basically just an invite to an amazing hotel, an amazing location to drive an amazing new car. And hilariously, I think it all started for us as YouTubers.
For sure.
With McLaren.
Absolutely.
If you think about it, the first one that we all went to as a group had was probably in town.
570 GT.
Of course, where you ended up falling in love with the LT Spider and then bought an LT. So that was an expensive press drive for you.
They can't
all
of
them are
that
expensive.
Well, you some did buy a 570 GT.
Buy a 540C.
But still, fundamentally, McLaren press drives are very expensive.
They know what they're doing.
Yeah, they do well. But yeah, you're right. It's a lot of waiting around. Well, actually, not always a lot of waiting around.
It depends on the style. If it's at a track, I find there's more waiting around than if it's a road drive.
But that can be nice.
For sure.
Because it allows time to shop on Auto Trader, as I did, or edit videos. but no, it's amazing. The only thing is, which I'm very aware of, is of course, the marketing and PR teams know what they're doing, and they put you in the best environment to experience that car.
Sure.
So it's a little jaded often, you know, you're on the most incredible roads, often in great weather, the cars are immaculate, you're given like amazing food, and you're like, wow, this is so wonderful. And you step away and don't realize that was a very bizarre experience.
What about the Rolls Royce one we went
to? One of the best. And can we tease that maybe there's another similar event coming in the not-too-distant future?
Yes.
Right.
Are you... Oh, so happy. So happy about that.
Okay.
It's big.
You've got to bring back the word Oculus. Has that dropped out of your dictionary?
I can bring it back.
Bring it back.
I can bring it back again. Oculus was a lot. I think I ran out of vocabulary that day.
But yeah, so that's the only thing that I would say is a negative, is that you're seeing the car in a very... in a sort of bit of a bubble. It's not a real world.
It's sometimes an insane reality distortion field bubble.
Absolutely. So you kind of come away thinking the car's better. From my side, you know, I didn't get into this to like review cars.
Yeah.
So the opportunity to drive any car anywhere in the world is always brilliant. So I find it very hard to be negative.
Yeah.
Because often I'm blown away by the location, it's a new car, whatever.
But okay, so I remember I was going to give your particular video a shout out in a previous video, and it never happened. But this is the prime opportunity.
Please.
So interesting from our side of things, because we don't come from the conventional journalistic background. We do immerse you in the wider lifestyle. And on our first launch, which Sam was talking about earlier, which is 570 GT in Tenerife, you and Seb got up at like 4 in the morning, or 3 in the morning.
Yes.
And I don't know what happened to me, but I was ill, and I was like, I don't want to join you until it. Anyway, so I woke up the next day, and they were like, this is just the best drive of my life. So I'm going to link below
to this video.
Because, and I hope you don't mind me saying this, it didn't get enough views.
No, it didn't, but it's slowly trickling up.
It's slowly trickling up.
Like this.
But go and check out the link below, because it's one of the most beautiful examples of why car launches can be so special.
There you go.
And these guys grabbed it by the horns and made the most of it by getting up at 3 in the morning and basically driving through the clouds.
Yeah, literally, we didn't know. It was the middle of the night, we drove up a volcano, we waited for the sun to rise, and it happened to be that we were above the clouds and the sun rose between the two cars we'd driven up the volcano.
I mean, it was ridiculous. It was like the best thumbnail I've probably seen on here today. It was incredible. So yeah, so check out that. Yes, so we're going to another continent soon. Something else. Tune in shortly. But this is where you come first thing in the morning. Everyone attending the event sits down on these benches and you're given a wonderful presentation as to the character of the car, the circuit that you're at, and your schedule of the day. It's really cool. Everyone meets the team, they meet everyone else who's on the event, and it's just great to see what you're about to do at the beginning of the day. Now don't forget, what I'm showing you around right now is just a pit garage. This is normally just an empty, plain pit garage. McLaren are out here for the best part of 3 weeks, and they set this place up to look like, well, this, basically a showroom that just so happens to be on a racetrack. They go to great lengths and detail to really immerse you in the brand and this incredible environment. Now, of course, outside it is 30 degrees. So what they've done here is provided little things that you may not have thought of, and they're providing things like suntan lotion and even custom branded 600 LT towels. Here's a man who knows a thing or two about arranging events like this. If you watch the channel regularly, you might remember that Hunter and I took a 570 Spider from Estoril to Portimão earlier this year after the Senna launch. Tell us a little bit what it's like, or what goes into the organization. Listen, I know it's huge, but the organization of these events, because they are incredible and we only dip in for a few days. You've been here for the best part of 3 weeks.
Yeah, so it's a fairly substantial project. We take a truck full of cars over to a racetrack like this. A lot of technicians. I think we've probably got 20 technicians.
Wow.
Full PR team, there's 6 or 7 of us. I've got a camera crew of 8. filming and photographing everything. Two wow. full-time retouchers and editors.
So seriously?
They're constantly generating content for us.
Wow, wow.
And then
okay.
we have dinner every single night yeah. at a hotel.
And journalists from every
single. So that's
basically.
Actually the best thing about it, to be yeah. honest with you. So I will meet people from all around the world every single night, and the right. conversation's never the same. It's always about cars.
For sure.
Conversation's never the same.
Yeah.
It's always interesting. Yeah. There's always different challenges, shall
yeah.
I say.
Yeah, sure.
And the best thing is that we get to then send them out the next day in these amazing cars.
Yeah.
And for me particularly, this one has been
awesome. It's great.
On point.
How often do you get to drive?
I think I'm one of the lucky ones. So
oh, really?
I get to drive okay. the car quite a lot.
Okay.
Because a lot of the filming and photography is
yeah.
either me supporting or in some cases me driving slowly. I'm not a very good driver. All the drifty good stuff is our pro drivers.
Okay, cool.
But yeah, so we will do all the production while you guys are here in the spare time we have. Sounds so
it's
good.
So good, isn't it? It is so, so cool. Amazing. Well, I'm not sure we have any more launches before the end of the year.
Thankfully, so I'm going to get some rest.
You were traveling a lot. You just came off the back of Car Week.
We did Pebble Beach.
Pebble
yes.
Beach.
That
also
was very
massive.
Cool. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Pebble Beach was great. So we did the MSO 600 LT at Pebble Beach with the roof scoop,
which looked amazing.
I mean, the thing is, it sounds so good anyway.
I bet when you're inside it though, the roof's
good
with the induction
cool.
sound.
Yes, it must
be
cool.
It's pretty cool.
I think I'm kind of sad to be. This is the last day, to yeah. be honest with you.
Well,
the
you look sunburnt enough to
I
go out.
I think I can't
Now's
get any
time.
More sunburned.
Now's
to be
the time.
With you.
Yeah. It's time to call it a day.
Yeah.
Thanks very much, man. I always appreciate your work. It's a great thing.
Thank you.
So that's a quick overview of what it's like to be on a brand new car launch. Granted, this one's a very special car launch. McLaren know how to do it big time. But I wanted to take you guys behind the scenes because this isn't something that you get to see every day of the week. So, if you're liking what you're seeing, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I always love hearing from you guys, and those subscriptions really help this channel grow. It's all because of you guys. As always, thanks so much for watching. I will see you next time. Ciao.